classification of organic compounds. So classification of organic compounds. So this is the subtopic. So classification of organic compounds. Generally, organic compounds are classified into two types. Organic compounds are classified into two types. One is acyclic or open chain compounds, and next one is cyclic or closed chain organic compounds. This acyclic and open chain compounds are classified into two types. One is saturated organic compounds, and next one is unsaturated organic compounds. Okay, this saturated organic compound example is alkane. This unsaturated organic compounds are classified into two types. One is double bond and triple bond. So these are generally considered examples. One is alkene and one is alkyne. Okay. Now cyclic or closed chain organic compounds are classified into two types. Alicyclic organic compounds, and next one is aromatic organic compounds. This alicyclic and aromatic, these aromatic organic compounds are classified into two types. One is benzenoid compound, next one is non-benzenoid compound. Okay. So alicyclic compound means these are containing cyclic ring. Okay, so your only normal chain is present, that alicyclic ring is called as aliphatic ring compounds. So this is the classification of organic compounds. Means organic compounds are classified into two types. One is acyclic open chain, means this is containing a straight chain structure, and cyclic compound, this is containing a closed ring structure, a cyclic ring or closed chain. Now before that, we have discussed first one, acyclic open chain compounds. So the acyclic compounds are classified into two types. One is saturated compounds and unsaturated organic compounds. The saturated compounds, so saturated compounds means these saturated compounds are containing only sigma bonds. Only sigma bonds are present. If in organic compound sigma bond is present, such compounds are called as saturated organic compounds. Examples are alkane. So here alkane, and this saturated organic compound, especially for alkanes, all alkanes are undergoes sp3 hybridization. It undergoes sp3 hybridization. And its bond angle is 109 degrees 28 minutes. So this is the bond angle for saturated organic compounds. Okay. And next one is unsaturated organic compounds. Here unsaturated organic compounds means these unsaturated organic compounds generally containing double bonds and triple bond. Okay. So double bond and triple bond is present. Such compounds are called as unsaturated organic compounds. These are the examples are alkene and alkyne. So here generally the ene containing here only double bonds are present. So in between the carbon double bond is present. For example, this one C double bond C. In between the carbon double bond is present. Such compounds are called as alkene. So generally alkenes are undergoes sp2 hybridization process, And next, alkyne. In that alkyne, here ion. Ion indicates triple bond. So, triple bond is present. So, means in between the carbon, triple bond is present. So, in alkane, in between the carbon, C bond C. Only single bond is present. That is alkane. Double bond is present. Alkene. In between the carbon, triple bond is present. That is alkyne. So, generally, these alkynes are undergoes sp hybridization. So, these are your acyclic or open chain organic compounds. Now, we discuss cyclic or closed chain organic compounds. So, cyclic means here all the carbons are linked like this. So, for example, this is your closed chain structure. Okay. If it is open chain structure, means, for example, you represent like this. CH3, CH2, CH3. This is your open chain. Means that is your straight chain structure. This is your cyclic structure. Or if you represent like this, this is also cyclic chain structure. Means all are the carbon atoms. So represent like this. So this is your closed chain. So ring. All the carbons are atoms are present. Or in between the carbon atom, if you represent like this. Okay. So this is also closed chain or ring chain type of structure. So in that alicyclic or aliphatic compounds, in aliphatic compounds only all carbon atoms are present. For example, this one, this is your cyclohexane. In that cyclohexane, all our carbon atoms are present. Only carbon links are present. These are the carbon atoms. This is your cyclopropane, because there are only three carbon atoms are present. That is your aliphatic compound. So these aliphatic compound and saturated organic compounds, both the properties are same. And next one is aromatic compound. These aromatic compounds are shows one special property in organic compounds, because these aromatic compounds are shows different chemical properties compared to remaining compounds. These aromatic compounds are exhibit 4n plus 2 pi rule. That rule is called as Hückel rule. So this is called as Hückel rule. These aromatic compounds are classified into two types. One is benzenide compounds and one is non-benzenide compounds. And generally these non-benzenide compounds are generally nothing but your heterocyclic compounds. Heterocyclic compounds are also present. Benzenide compound means your only benzene ring is present. For example, this is your structure. This is your benzene. On benzene, if it is written methyl group, this is your methyl benzene. Or on the benzene, if you represent ethyl group, C2H5, this is your ethyl benzene. Means all the rings are present. Within the ring, your double bonds. And these are your benzenide compound, because this structure is similar to benzene. So non-benzenide compounds. Non-benzenide compounds means, for example, if you represent cyclopentadienyl cation. So this is our 5-member ring. This 5-member ring is containing cyclopentadienyl cation or anion. Or if you consider your tropylium cation, the tropylium cation is your 7-member ring. Okay, this is your 7-member ring. Okay, cyclotropylium cation. So those are the non-benzenide ring. So heterocyclic compounds means the heterocyclic compounds examples are, if you consider this is your 6-member ring, that 6-member means within the ring here hetero atom is present. That is a nitrogen atom. This is called as pyridine. Or another heterocyclic compound example is, if it is your 5-member ring, okay, or if you consider a 5-member ring, within the 5-member ring here sulfur atom is present. This is called as thiophene. Or within the 5-member ring, it containing oxygen atom. This is called as pyrene. This is called as furan. This is thiophene. This is pyridine. So these are your heterocyclic compounds. Means the organic compounds are classified into two types. One is open chain and one is ring chain. The open chains are two types, saturated and unsaturated. Saturated example is alkene. Unsaturated organic compounds are containing double bond or triple bond. Double bond is, such compounds are called as alkene. This is your alkyne. Alkyne is consist of triple bond. And cyclic or ring chain structure, one is helicyclic and aromatic. Aromatic is two types, benzenide and non-benzenide compounds.